We are given a metric space s comma d. Define the following function d1 s comma y equal d of xy all over 1 plus d of xy for all x and y in the set in the metric space. Show that s comma d1 is also a metric space. Now, we are told first that s comma d is a metric space. We want to show that s comma d1 is also a metric space. So that means this d is a metric. And if d is a metric, it satisfies all the metric property. So recall that. So before I can start this proof, we have to remember some things. So that is why I wrote this out. Recall that s comma d is said to be a metric space if all these properties hold, that is d of s comma y is always positive, is always greater than or equal to zero for any two sets, two elements you pick from the set. Now the second one, d of s comma y is equal to zero if and only if s is equal to y. So it's equal to zero if and only if s equal to y. Then the third one, that is symmetric, d of s comma y is equal to d of y comma x. Then the last one, the triangle inequality, d of s comma y is less or equal to d of s comma z plus d of z comma y. So these are all the properties we are going to show. So we want to show that d1 satisfy all these four properties. So once I can prove that d1 satisfy all these four properties, I am done proving that a set or s comma d1 is a metric space. So let's get started. Now we have d1. We need to show that d1, we need to prove the first one, d1 of s comma y is equal to d of s comma y all over 1 plus d of s comma y. So obviously we know that we want to prove that this is greater than or equal to 0. We want to prove this now. Look at what I'm going to do. The first thing I'm going to do here is, since, don't forget, we are told that S, D is a metric space. So that means this satisfies the metric property. So this satisfies all these properties. So we know that D of S, Y is greater than or equal to 0. So we know that already because D itself is a metric. 1 plus D of S, Y will be greater than or equal to 1. So at the end of the day, by the time you do D of S, Y, if you plus 1 plus D of S, Y, this will be greater than or equal to 0 over 1, which is 0. So, and this is exactly the definition of D1. So that means that D1 of x, y is greater than or equal to 0. I'm done proving the first property. Now, what is this trying to tell me? How do I know? If you divide two positive numbers, the answer you are going to obtain will also be a positive number. So that is why I have to prove this. So I have proved that D1 is greater than or equal to 0. So that we don't confuse things up, let X, Y, and Z come from the set X. So now let's go to the next one. We want to prove that D1, we want to go to the next thing. So B, that is B. We want to prove that D1 of S comma Y is equal to 0 if and only if S is equal to Y. That is the second thing we want to prove. So now let D1 of S comma Y be equal to 0. So don't forget, this is D of s comma y all over 1 plus d of s comma y is equal to 0. By the time you clear fraction, this implies this, by the time you clear the fraction, if you multiply both sides by 1 plus d of s comma y, you will be left with d of s comma y is equal to 0. Now d of s comma y is a metric space. So it's actually implied that S is equal to Y because D itself is a metric. I'm using the property of D of a metric. And this satisfies all the property of the metric because S, D is a metric space. So it implies that S equal Y. Now, conversely, you know, if and only if means from the right to the left, then from the left to the right. So conversely, you can just start from down. Let S be equal to Y. Then come up this way. It means that D of S, Y equals 0. Then you come to this one. Then you are back to the question 2. This if and only if has helped me prove the forward and backward proof. So I'm done. The third one. We want to prove that D1 of S, Y is equal to D1 of Y, X. That is the third thing we want to prove. So again, what is D1 of S, Y? D1 of S, Y is equal to D of S, Y all over 1 plus D of X, Y. And D is a metric. Since D is a metric, I can swap. This becomes D of Y, S all over 1 plus D of Y, S. Is symmetric. It satisfies all the property of a metric. So this is equal to D1 of Y, S. So I've already proved that D1 of S, Y is equal to D1 of Y, S. No, now the last thing, we want to prove the triangle inequality, that is D1 of S, Y is less or equal to D of S, Z plus D1 of S, Z plus D1 of Z, Y. That is the last step property we want to prove. So we have a D1. What is D1 of S, Y? Obviously, this is equal to D of S, Y all over 1 plus D of S, Y. Now, we know that D is a metric. D itself satisfies. We know that D itself satisfies the metric property. So D of S, Y is actually less or equal to D of S, Z plus D of Z, Y. That is the first thing you have to know in this case. So add 1 to both sides. I have 1 plus D of S, Y less or equal to 1 plus D of S, Z plus D of Z, Y. Now reciprocate, this one will become 1 over 1 plus D of S, Z. Whenever you reciprocate, the inequality change. So this becomes greater than or equal to 1 over 1 plus D of S, Z plus D of Z, Y. Now I will multiply both sides by negative 1. Multiply both sides by minus 1. This is minus 1 all over 1 plus D of S, Y. Of course, when you multiply by negative sign, the inequality changes again. So it becomes less or equal to. So this is minus 1 all over 1 plus D of S, Z plus D of Z, Y. So, what am I going to do next? The next thing I'm going to do is add 1 to both sides again. This is 1 minus 1 over 1 plus D of S, Y. This will be less or equal to 1 minus 1 over 1 plus D of S, Z plus D of Z, Y. That is what I'm going to have. Now, by the time you take the LCM here, by the time you make this a single fraction, you will get, make that in a single fraction, find the LCM, you get D of S, Y all over 1 plus D of S, Z, S, Y. And this will be less or equal to D of S, Z plus D of Z, Y all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y. So now this way, this will become d of s comma y all over 1 plus d of s comma y. This will be less or equal to d of s comma z all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y plus d of z comma y all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y. So now eventually, let me call this 1, 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y will actually be greater than or equal to 1 plus d of s comma z only. Why? Because everything here are positive numbers. So 1 plus a positive number plus another positive number will obviously be greater than 1 plus just a positive number. Do you understand? So it will be greater than or equal to. So reciprocate. This will become 1 over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y. And this will be less or equal to 1 over 1 plus d of s comma z. Multiply the numerator by d of s comma z. So I have d of s comma z all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y, and this will be less or equal to d of s comma z all over 1 plus d of s comma z. So we can see that this is less or equal to this. Similarly, following the same way, I will also have d of z comma y all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y will also be less or equal to d of z comma y all over 1 plus d of z comma y. The same thing happens to that case as well. The way we prove this, that is how we get this one as well. So that at the end of the day, from 1, now coming back from 1, what do we have from 1? We have d of s comma y. D of s comma y all over 1 plus d of s comma z will now be less or equal to all this. D of s comma z. Now let me write it. D of s comma z all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y plus d of z comma y all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d of z comma y. So this one, only this one, is less or equal to, you can see it here, d of s comma z all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus d comma y is less or equal to this. So the only this one is less or equal to d of s comma z all over 1 plus d of s comma z plus, now this second one as well is also less or equal to this. So this becomes d of z comma y all over 1 plus d of z comma y. Do you understand? So it means that d of s comma y is less or equal to 1 plus d of s comma y. So I just remove this middle, write this first one, then this one, so that at the end of the day, this is obviously d1 of s comma y less or equal to d1 of s comma z plus d1 of z comma y. So that I can just conclude, since I have proved all the four properties, D1, S comma D1, S comma D1 is a metric space, and that is all.